sufficiently high, are inexhaustible as heaven and earth. Unending is the flow of rivers and streams. Like the sun and moon, they end but to begin anew. Like the four seasons, they pass away to return once more.
How you gonna try to be someone when the people can't see you? How you gonna try to open those doors when you don't use a handle? You can't walk till you move and you're in control. Riding through, be in touch with the vibrations. Ooh, oh, yeah, ride those vibrations.
accept your punishment. Now, if you just stand up straight and you tell them, yeah, I shorted you and I'm left around and I didn't save that money and I can pay you back. Yeah, probably the worst thing that's gonna happen to you is a black eye, a bloody nose, and some broken fingers. But if you try to blow it off and deny it and come up with some lame-ass excuse, you're gonna be the prime ingredient in his favorite recipe, which consists of three ingredients, a plastic bag, duct tape, and a trunk. Take a look at these tire tracks on my back that go from the top of my head down to my ass. Tire tracks on my back that go from the top of my head down to my ass. Take a look at these tire tracks on my back that go from the top of my head down to my ass.
Defying show the weak on love. is a folk song that I picked up there while I was fishing on the Tillamook River. You have to imagine the West as it was in 1833, and how people had so few resources, access to technologies, high bandwidth communications. All they had were wagons and a lot of heavy things that generally are a 16th of their weight they are today. Oftentimes, these people had a lot of dirty clothing. They were unable to bathe. Flies tend to be a regular part of their day. They also played harmonicas by fires, usually, and they usually traded off every night. Someone different would play, even if they couldn't. And then they would also tend to ride around going, yee-haw, whoop-haw, and whatever else worked. So with that in mind, this is where that folk song tends to emanate from. By the way, this is my cousin Carlos. He's a professional soccer attorney. And I don't know, we've done a lot of great stuff together, so it's good to have you here. Okay, so check this out. Probably one of the most touching yet tragic moments in history ever again. In 1943, Carl Imsford invented the rocket. This rocket was placed aboard a small child and then hurled into the ocean, where it apparently did not work. At that time, rockets were a really big craze. Everyone was after them. Everyone wanted one. No one knew what they were at the same time. Wrong about maybe 3 years after the invention of the first rocket, which was the V-7. It had a turbine compulsion compressor, made an antimatter chamber, that was, I believe, at the time, also constructed a pure uranium. Anyways, many of the people began to fascinate over the rocket technology and where this could lead us, possibly into space, how would it change our lives? Would something like a rocket change our lives? And of course, many of you today know that we tend not to use rockets so much in everyday life. For instance, many people back then thought that rockets could use toast food products. this was expensive and generally did a lot more harm than tasty goodness. Also, people believe that rockets may someday make for a really, really entertaining thing of some sort. Well, as we all know, rockets are way too expensive and definitely not worth it to a party. Well, as we all know, rockets are way too expensive.
I'm giving up so early. think of when you gonna give my soul? Not far ahead. Yeah, yeah. Now people be saying that you got so much chewy and different things that make you rush to hopefully admire something that might make. Things that make you rush to hopefully admire something that might make you a taller person and not on the take. You a taller person and not on the take. You a taller person and not on the take. You a taller person and not on the take.
Stop.